Figma just added Nano Banana to its image editing capabilities. How can that help you as a designer? Let's look at it together, how you can attach an image for reference, what you can do and what still you cannot do with it. For the purpose of this video, I'm gonna show you how I created a thumbnail.
I started with a screenshot image that looked like this. I gave it the instruction to change my clothes into professional black suit with a white shirt. It did that perfectly.
Then selecting the image, I asked it to make my background more engaging and less busy, and then to add a Figma logo and Nano Banana logo. Now the background worked all right, it looked good, but it definitely missed the logos. It did not recognize Figma as a logo and definitely not Nano Banana either. Next, I selected Edit Image again and I asked it to remove that small thumbnail in the right side of the image. And it's actually pretty good at recognizing objects. It removed it perfectly. Next, I asked it to boost the resolution of my image to get clearer features. But that's the part that it's not good at. When it was done, my image looked very artificial and the face did not even look like me. I'm not sure if this part of Figma is using Nano Banana or the other GPT image, but it's not working really well. Next, to understand how much context it can have, I asked it to replace my background with a dahlia field, which is a very specific flower, to see if it will get that. And it did. My background was filled with dahlias. So it's good with understanding context and replacing the background accordingly. So I didn't want the dahlias. I tried to remove the background and gave direction that it removes the dahlias without distorting my face. But then look what happened. It thought it removed the background, but it only placed a white background behind it. That's not at all what I wanted. Then I wanted to see if it understood how to add effects, like softening the edge of an image to blend with the background. So I added that instruction to soften the image edge on the right side. But it had absolutely no context what I'm asking it to do. Nothing changed in my image. Then I extended the background of the image and I asked it to fill the whole frame with the image background. But it did not get that either. So I decided to remove the background once again and I did it through the edit image with Nano Banana. But just like before, it couldn't do it this way. There's another way to do this in Figma though. With the Figma AI, there's a remove image. And I think for that, they're using a different GPT and not Nano Banana. And that does it perfectly in Figma. So remember, use the Figma remove background, not the edit image in the Nano Banana. And it's pretty good at removing objects. So do you see this other background I created for my image? I wanted to remove the astronaut from in between. So I prompted it to remove the astronaut and it got that really well. I attempted to get a Nano Banana logo again. I prompted it after creating a frame, but I don't think it gets the concept of a logo because what it provided me with is a very funny image with a banana in it. So I went back to Google and got my own Nano Banana logo. I also went ahead and brought my own Figma logo since the concept of logo was not clear. Lastly, I wanted to create a funny background that had flowers and bananas also in the meadow. So I prompted it to change my background. And it did that, as you can see, flower meadows with bananas in it. And I used that as a background to adjust. I've tried prompting it to remove the black margins from the background itself, but it did not get that concept also. So the concept of margins was unfamiliar, so I had to resize it myself. If you want to cut the image, just crop it. I clicked command and resized it so that resized the edges of the image. And then I created a new frame that has the correct thumbnail ratio, which is 16 by 9, as provided in the Figma presentation frames ready-made. And then I resized all my elements as I wanted for the thumbnail. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Stay tuned for more.